Hey, what's up? What's up? It's your boy, the Athlete's Mentor, aka the Dragon. I'm back with another one. All right, so today's topic of the video is what type of workouts should you be doing? All right, so walk with me, talk with me. I'm out in nature getting this sunlight. All right, let's get it cracking. So the simple answer to the question is, what are your goals? That will determine the type of workouts you should be doing. It should all be based off your goals. So if you're an athlete, let's say you're a football player and you want to increase your speed, you need to be doing exercises that will benefit you in increasing your speed. If your goal is to lose weight, you need to be doing exercises that are going to benefit you in losing weight. If your goal is to gain muscle, you need to be doing exercises that are going to help you pack on muscle. So the simple answer is, what are your goals? And that will determine what type of workouts you should be doing. All right, so let's go a little bit further into detail on what type of exercises work, what type of goals you have. So for instance, if I am a track and field sprinter, I know that I need to be working on short burst and power movements. All right, I know the hamstrings and the glutes are very important when it comes to developing linear speed. So that should be one of my focuses. Squats, sprints, weighted sprints, sleds, glute activation, hip exercises, core work, that's a foundation. If I'm a basketball player, I want to jump higher. I need to be working similar muscles to that. I need to be doing heavy squats. I need to be doing lots of box jumps, lots of plyometrics, lots of band work, strong core. If my goal is to lose weight, then I need to be doing exercises that are going to be burning lots of calories. High intensity exercises. I'm not just going to go for basic walks. All right. Yes, that will aid in the journey, but it'll be a slower process. So if I go into a gym and I start doing things like interval training on a treadmill, or if I start doing high intensity exercises similar to what athletes do, but on a more basic level, like a simple box hop, as opposed to an athletic box hop where they're gonna stack the box up as high as they can and try to jump really high. That's not necessary for you because you could get injured. So you wanna do a basic box hops, you know, but you wanna do it with intensity. You know, as rapidly as you can with good form. Also, stuff like jump roping, stuff like weight training. Weight training is very good. You're not training to be a power lifter. You're not training to get stronger for sports. So if your goal is simply to lose weight, you need to train to burn fat. And by doing that, you want to go push yourself to lighter weight, but getting close to failure or pushing yourself to failure on the reps. If my goal is to build muscle, I want to get stronger. Whether it be just for looks, whether it be for sports, then that's going to determine the type of training. So if I want to get stronger just for looks, I need to do lots of reps. Depending on the time length I have of the day in training, that will determine how intense I will be going during my sessions. If I only have 45 minutes, then I'm going to have to go very intense for the whole day. If I only got 45 minutes, because I, you know, I got work, I got kids, whatever, I need to be going to failure. My workouts have to be intense in order for me to receive results. If not, you won't receive the desired results. So if I have longer periods to work out through the day, I can bring down the intensity, right? And then I can lift longer. So what that does is it'll reduce the probability of me getting some type of knick-knack injury and allow me to still get the desired results from putting strain on the muscle. All right, so high repetitions for those who are trying to gain weight and lots of reps. Lower weight. Now, if I'm an athlete and I want to get stronger, I'm going to go above that, and I'm going to add stuff like bands and chains. And I'm going heavier weight. So the difference between an athlete and a person just wants to pack on muscle, an athlete's training with the goal to get a lot stronger for performance. with that comes a slightly greater chance of injury too. So if your body's not healthy, or particularly if you have old injuries, I don't recommend you lift heavy. You don't need to. It's not worth it. But if you're a young athlete trying to get better for sport, you need to lift heavy, you know. And also you need to be doing complementary exercises to strengthen up areas such as the lower back, the hamstrings, you know, and not just focusing on your compound lifts like the bench, squat, and deadlift, but those are the cores. But you can be doing other stuff as well. So if I want to get my bench press stronger, I need to do not only regular bench press, but I need to be doing dumbbell bench presses. I need to add bands. I can do chains, etc. So the type of training you should be doing should be based off your particular goals. All right. If you're a marathon runner, you need to be focusing on such things as core. Your core has to be strong. Your hamstrings and lower back need to be strong. All right. Even if you're just a 5K runner, you need to strengthen up your core, your lower back, and your hamstrings. Practice running form. Get on treadmill. That type of stuff. All right. Football players, you are a combination of all these different things. You know, you have to be strong, you have to be fast, you have to be agile. So you have to do all this type of training. You can't just be in the weight room all day and think you're going to be a great football player. It ain't going to happen, especially when you get on a high level. You might dominate in high school, but when you get to somebody who's been training for speed, training for power and agility, he's going to probably crush you. And plus, he's been doing sport-specific drills. He's probably going to crush you. Same thing with basketball, you know. You can't just be in the weight room lifting. You need to be doing agility work. You need to be doing some conditioning work. Same thing with tennis. You know, a lot of agility work you need to be doing. A lot of strength and power. You know, you got to be able to hit the ball with force. A lot of core. All my athletes need to have strong core, strong lower back, strong hamstrings. You need to have these things. Football players, you need to have strong necks. Do a lot of neck training to prevent concussions. All right. So I hope this video answers you guys' questions. I'm going to show some basic exercises and explain them, and use this knowledge to benefit your life and, you know, make your dreams become a reality. Hey.
Ready? Go! Come on, drive. Drive them arms. Drive them arms. Dig. 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 Good. 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 Turn around. Turn around. There you go. Drive them on a bit closer, bit closer. Ready, go! Come on, drive, dig, 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 dig. All right, feet. Drive it up, good. There we go. Good. Good. Drive it up. Come on with it, stay quick and explosive. Quick, 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 quick. Quick, 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 quick. There you go. Get there. Hip flip, hip. Yep, 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 yep. Flip those hips. Good. Middle call. There you go. Back to the middle. Good. Stay quick. There you go. Good. Good. Get to the hurdles. Quick, quick. Bunny hops, bunny hops, bunny hops. There you go. There you go. In and out, out. Quick feet, quick feet, quick feet, quick feet, quick feet. Good, good. Sprint. Weave, 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 weave. Good money.
Come on, man, there you go. Nice.